Hi. Welcome to Simply Maker channel. This channel is about how to simply make your own gadgets on a budget. If you like to make things, hit subscribe to get an update and regularly receive the new idea. Today let's make this. A simple mini DC multimeter. If you regularly need to measure DC voltage and amp, like I do, this little guy will make your life a lot easier. Before we begin, let's talk about the basics of electronic measurement. If you need to measure the voltage, the first choice is a digital multimeter. A digital multimeter like this is an accurate device for measuring electronic values. It can quickly measure voltage. But, if you need to measure the circuit amperage, unlike the voltage measurement, you need to connect the red lead to the specific amp's terminal. And connect the meter in series between the battery and load. If you need to measure both units simultaneously, you will need an additional multimeter. With a module like this, it can display both values at the same time. It can measure up to 100 volts. It has a built-in shunt that can measure up to 10 amps. There are larger modules that can display voltages, amperages, power, and temperatures and also record run time. It can measure up to 200 volts and 10 amps. If you need to measure higher currents, you need to use external shunts. The larger shunt allows you to measure up to 100 amps. For this project, I will use this little one. It needs a 5 to 24 volt power supply to run. If the circuit you like to measure is within the board's working voltage, it is possible to use power from the circuit. To measure amps, the load has to connect to the board in a series, similar to a digital multimeter measurement. You can easily hook it up with a breadboard and some jumper wires. This is what cables look like when completing the circuit. It's quite messy and may confuse many people, especially a newbie. There is still a lot of room for errors and frustration to rewire it every time, even for an expert. But we can simplify this mess. We can pre-wire all the wiring within the enclosure. The enclosure also has a selector switch for selecting the power source for powering the board. With the enclosure, just hook up the battery or power supply to the input terminal. Then plug in the load. Turn on the main switch and start measuring. The enclosure consisted of three 3D print parts. The main case, and top and bottom cover. We will start with the main case. Use M3 by 4mm heat insert nuts. Insert the nuts into all the provided holes. There are 4 holes on the top and 5 on the bottom. Set the soldering iron temperature to match your printed filament. Use conical soldering iron tips to push the nut into place. Attach the meter board to the top cover using 4 M2 button head screws. Now we are ready for wiring. Here is the wiring diagram for the enclosure. I already included a link to the diagram on my website in the description below. Many of my devices use banana jacks. So I designed the enclosure to have both banana connectors and the screw terminal blocks, which you can connect with bare wire. Each connector is jumped together. If you didn't use banana jacks, you can just discard them. This will make wiring a lot simpler. Start with the battery and load connector. On each banana terminal, I use 2 wires twisted together and solder to the banana jacks ring connector. For the red one, one of the wires will connect together and another end will connect to the screw terminal. On each screw terminal end, jumped an additional small wire for an internal power wire and a voltage measurement wire. Now, you can mount all the banana jacks to the enclosure. Next, use a utility knife to cut off 2 blocks from the screw terminal strip. Trim out the plastic at the screw holes to shorten the block to match the enclosure. Then use sandpaper to smoothen the edge. use the M2.5 self-tap screws to mount the terminal block to the enclosure. Next, we will work on the DC input for an external power source. I use this plastic 5.5mm DC connector with a 2.1mm center pole. The cut hole for the connector is 12mm. There are three pins on the back. For most connections, the center pole is for the positive. The pin for the center pole is the largest one with bending metal. The other two are for the ground. If you're using a different type of connector and not sure about the pinout, it's a good idea to recheck it with a multimeter. Now use a soldering iron to weld a positive wire to the center pin and ground wire to one of the ground pins. Then cover both connectors with shrink tubes. Assemble the connector to the enclosure. Solder the wires to the KCD11 rocker switch and insert it into the enclosure. Now, we have to connect the selector switch which mounts to the bottom cover. Please note that the enclosure in the video is the first version. In the revised model I uploaded, the switch mount is 1mm deeper. So the switch handle will completely sink into the case. This will prevent the switch from accidentally swapping. I use 2-position 3-pole slide switch. The handle is about 5.7mm long. First, connect the wire from the rocker switch to the center pin. Then connect the wire from the DC connector positive to either pin on the side. And the last pin will connect to a wire from the screw terminal block. Attach the switch to the bottom cover. Secure it with 5mm button head M2.5 screws. Close the bottom cover and use flathead M3 screws to secure it to the main case. Connect all the wires to the board. Start with the small terminal. Connect the negative wire from the DC connector to the screw terminal label with G. Then connect the wire from the rocker switch to the middle terminal labeled with I. These two wires are the power supply lines for the board. Connect the small wire from the terminal block to the last terminal label with O. This one is for voltage measurement. For the large terminal block, connect the wire from the load to the terminal on the left, and the wire from the battery to the last terminal hole. Close the top cover. And secure it with 4 button head M3 screws. I think that's it. I hope you enjoy this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to add them in the comment. And if you found this video helpful, please consider giving me a like and subscribe to receive more cool DIY ideas. Happy making. Thank you for watching.